Okay, so someone brought up a great question about Aptana Studio 3. When you first use the program, it is not necessarily the most user-friendly, but it has so many powerful features that I encourage you to get through it because you will appreciate it once you've learned how to navigate the program. So to create and save your first web file, it's not as easy as you think. If you go to File and New, and just create a file, if you try to save it, test.html, you're like, wait, I can't finish. It won't let me save. Where's the save button? And you get frustrated. So click cancel and let me show you the best way to start first time. On the left-hand side, you have this folder and a plus sign. If you hover over it, it says new. Click on that. And then it opens the wizard. We love wizards, right? They help us. Click on Web Project and then Basic Web Template and then click Next and then title your project name. Now this is what is going to be the title of the folder. So think of each project as each website, right? So this is the folder name, not the file name. So I'm going to call this test. And then it's going to show you where it's saving it, which is in the Aptana Studio 3 workspace folder that was created when you first downloaded the program. That is mine. Click finish. And now we can go to file new and you'll see it's a totally different experience. So if we go to file, new, and then file, now we'll see this test folder here in the middle. So click on that and now try to type in your file name. And you will notice now we can click finish. It does let us. And once we do that, voila, we have our first file, our first template ready to go and we can start doing our code. Now it's also helpful to see the Project Explorer on the left because then you can understand your file structure. When you first open the program, it may have shown up, but in the event it didn't, like right now, I don't have a File Explorer open. I can just go to Window, Show View, and then Project Explorer. And when I do that, it opens up this column here on the left, and then I can open these triangles here and see the file structure. And notice this is what I created through the wizard, the test. And then this is that file I just created and saved. It's right here. But now I can see where it's at so that I can easily, as I add more files, jump between them. And all I have to do is double click and it will open each file. So hopefully that helped you get started. I know it's intimidating to use this program at first. There's a lot of tools that and it can accomplish quite a bit. But stick to it because it's worth it. It's one of the very few free applications out there that has a built-in web server. And hope that helped. I will see you next time.